Alright, what's happening? Has Ollie failed at Manchester United? With Manchester United getting beat off PSG in the Champions League, questions are around Ollie now. Woodward has came out and said that they'll back him, but in the summer window, which is a bit worrying. The match against West Ham United this weekend will be a big one. West Ham sit fifth, off of a 2-1 win against Aston Villa. While under the time they have with Moyes, they've been playing very well compared to United's better dodgy defensive display. While United did win at Southampton last week, 3-2, with an Edinson Cavani double off the bench, they sit ninth in the Premier League table. A win for either club will put them fourth, just temporarily. United need to win to keep the Champions League push going. Well, West Ham only we would say expected for probably a mid-table finish this season. I could see this person just being a 2-each draw. Both teams will score. I think it would just be it could either be that, or West Ham could win 2-3-0 with it being at the London Stadium, as United don't have a good track record there, as we all know. After United did lose against PSG in the week, their Champions League knockout qualification hopes are in the balance. All they need to do is avoid a defeat against RB Leipzig away in Germany next week, and they will qualify. Overall, Ollie will need to be a bit more tactical minded in this game against West Ham. As you can clearly tell, David Moyes has got West Ham playing fairly decently in attack, fairly good at defending, all round play. Declan Rice will be looking to dictate play from deep. Well, Mikel Antonio will probably body Harry Maguire and Victor Lindelof combined with fair ease. I do think, as I've said, it'll be a 2-each draw. I can't see Manchester United getting a win here, unless they play a full strength team and they drop McTominay and Fred for Paul Pogba and Van der Beek. Moving into our second game is Manchester City versus Fulham. Man City sit 11th after a 5-0 win against Burnley and qualify for the Champions League knockout with a 0-0 draw, topping the group away against Porto. Fulham sit 17th, just above the drop, after a 2-1 win against Leicester, surprisingly, looking to build momentum. A win for City puts them 4th temporarily, but it is dependent on what the United or West Ham result will be later on in the day. A win for Fulham will put them just one place higher. It will be joint 16th, as there is a good few points between them and 15th. I'm predicting a 4-0 win for Manchester City, with this being at the Etihad. I can see City picking up a few good results now on a good run, with Pep Guardiola now having to get results right. He can't mess about, as his job isn't as secure as what you'd think. He has been backed fairly well, I think £750 million plus spent within a 4-year spell. He needs to get it right this summer, or he will be out. Watching the result back for both teams, the previous one, Fulham did play well. Probably a wee bit iffy with the goal they conceded, but as Fulham, they're expected to be a relegation battling team under Scott Parker this season. Well, Man City, you know they're defensively dodgy, with Mitrovic in the attack of Fulham. A big number 9 could easily cause trouble for Pep Guardiola's side. But on the other hand, we know Man City could easily walk up at the Etihad, scud 6 or 7 past Fulham, and it'll be a simple day in the office. But also, it could be a 1 or 2-0 win for Fulham, and it could put even more pressure on the Pep Guardiola's men. Match 3 is Chelsea versus Leeds United, 8 o'clock kickoff. Chelsea sit third after a 0-0 draw against Tottenham Hotspur. Chelsea have now qualified top of the group after a 4-0 win against Sevilla in the Champions League, while Leeds sit 12th after a 1-0 win against Everton from a good strike from Rafinha. Win for Chelsea puts them top temporarily until the Sunday matches are played between Leicester and Liverpool. A win for Leeds will put them 8th. Both teams are playing very, very well. I can see this being a 2-1 win for Chelsea. Ultimately, I think the way you've got Frank Lampard playing the, after a very good result in midweek with Giroud scoring 4, you see the way that they're playing, getting their main ball players on the ball dictating the play. They're definitely really becoming a good force to reckon with. Leeds under Marcel Bielsa, where I got his name, they have been playing very well also. It's two evenly matched teams. This could easily just be another Chelsea-Tottenham game where it's all hyped up and then it's a 0-0 draw. It could easily, easily be that. I don't think it will be, as I don't think the other two games I've predicted will be a boring game. But that it could easily be, as I predicted a 1-0 win for Burnley last week against City. City won 5-0. 2-1 for Liverpool, they drew 1 each. 3-2 for Everton, they lost 1-0. I'm not the best at giving predictions, it's just my honest opinion. The teams are playing very well, but we need to wait and see how it goes going into this festive period of where each team is kind of playing. Well, the top six teams are playing, the European teams are playing about 6 or 7 games within the month of December, which that will take a toll on the teams, both mentally and physically. I think with that, I have talked enough about the day's episode. 7 minutes in. If you haven't already, leave a like, it really helps the channel. Subscribe to the channel also if you haven't already. It does help grow the channel more than you think. Share it with everyone you can. Work, colleagues, friends, family members, even with your next door neighbour. There is a link in the description for footyourcards.com for the Twitter account for the channel. Not for the channel, for them. It's a 25% off Christmas sale with free shipping within the United Kingdom as long as you order before the 20th of December to guarantee arrival for Christmas. There is also going to be a link for the official Twitter account for the channel. Don't go over there, drop a follow, everything helps. Hope you've had a good week. I'll catch you all for Monday's episode for this 3-game review. Hope you enjoy your weekend. And goodbye.